Hey everyone, how's it going? I thought I'd do a little follow-up video on the well pump replacement here. So I have my trusty friend with me, the old pump that I took out that was bad. I can't say that this was a bad pump. It lasted for 22 years, and 22 years and we have five of us in the house for most of those years, and four of those in the house are lady folk, okay? So just imagine this poor pump has had to pump showers for hours and hours every day for all the lady folk in my house and me, although I'm extremely quick. Anyway, it is a Goulds, G-O-U-L-D-S pump, submersible pump, and the model number is 10GS05412, and I believe it's a 10 GPM gallons per minute pump. You know, seems like the real deal. I believe this is a good brand name. So, you know, I can't really tell too much from here. I mean, I see there, you know, it splits apart here, and it's got a check valve up here. This is all made, you know, a nice casting there, right? Looks like a couple of screws down here. So how it comes apart, I don't know. And if it doesn't really appear to come apart, that's why we have grinders down there that will just grind this thing apart, because it's going in the trash anyway. So, all right, let's see what's in there. So here's the motor for it, and the motor says Franklin. No, I can't really quite read it here. Get the right light maybe. Franklin something. Franklin Electric model whatever whatever, volts 230 amps, 5 amps, 3400 and 50 RPMs, so on. You know, the thing with the motor was still turning on it, so I presume that this is actually still good. You know, it doesn't have the capacitor in here, obviously. The capacitor and control is up in the house. You know, usually you couldn't just plug this into 230 and make a motor out of it. I'm thinking it's just gonna go in there in the trash, because what in the world would I do with this? I've got other half horse electric motors, so that's pretty much it. You know, you saw the seal on the bottom, seals and stuff on the bottom end here, how that is. So goodbye for this. All right, so here we have the pump. There, that little connector there is kind of loose. That thing is loose. There, I don't know if that was a problem or what. Yeah, how do we get this apart now? I don't know how it comes apart. So I know how we're gonna do it. We're gonna do it with the grinder method. If you've ever seen the grinder method before, well, here it goes. We'll be right back. guess this thing here was just threaded in there, which I could have taken off that way. There's a little check valve right there. Right in there. You see that? Check valve. Probably good. Garbage. Our housing, which is just that, threaded on both sides. Garbage. Okay, so it was threaded onto the bottom there, and then in here, so the water must have come in through the bottom here, right? And I guess evidently, how else could it go, right? And it's got all these little doohickeys on it here. This one here stayed stationary, I presume. No, that turned too. That turned. It's got all these guys here. So that was all stacked together. So and then I've got the center here, which is kind of the same material as these here. I don't really know exactly how this thing worked, but I'm gonna kind of guess that part of the problem here with the pump is that, okay, the shaft turned this, right? The shaft turned this, and so the shaft would be turning all of these things here. I'm gonna guess that the problem was is that these things were no longer attached to the shaft. And somehow these became broke off or something. I'm not sure exactly what happened there. But I can tell you one thing, before I took the pump part apart, this thing here was loose in there. And that definitely doesn't seem right, so. All right, well, that was kind of fun. I had no idea what I was gonna get into looking in this pump, how to take it apart. Anything. So we learned a little bit about how it works, and I suppose if you're really desperate, you'd even learn how to take it apart and replace the pieces and what might go bad. From what I can tell, and I'm no expert on this pump, the only thing I can tell is that these things here, or portions of them, whatever, are supposed to be connected to this shaft and turn when the motor turns. And all of these just came right off of here, didn't seem to be connected to the shaft at all. You can see there's a little snap ring. I don't know if you can see that. There's a little snap ring there on the top, which tells me if I took the snap ring off, all of these things would slide off of this shaft here. And presumably those pieces of plastic were attached to the pieces of plastic in here, to these things here. Well, so that's probably why we lost pressure in stages, is because, you know, a couple of these broke off and then we lost a little bit of pressure, and pretty soon another one broke off, and it was just catastrophic until they all broke off, and that was all she wrote. Anyway, I'm not a pump expert, but you got to see the inner workings of a pump, so that's probably useful for somebody like me that likes to do things themselves and repair occasionally. Thanks for watching. We'll see you around.